All right, guys, back the diesel heater, kind of doing a quick update. We've had some comments on it. I've had some comments on it. There's kind of one thing unfinished and I want to finish it tonight. So we're going to just do a quick video and show you what I am working on. So when I left this off, we were all good. You know, everything was working well, but there was one thing I kind of left out. And that was this cap. And look at that. Look at that. Yeah. Whew, smells like diesel even. So left a little fuel in it. I need to get this thing fixed. I don't want to be draining it every time. It's a pain in the butt. But it's working great. Having no issues with the lines. Having no issues with using no filter. These are all working good. I have ran this probably 50 hours since I've the last video has been posted. It's been awesome. I've had no issues with it, so success. So now, got to keep this thing from leaking. I don't want to be, you know, I'm not going to carry diesel in it all the time, but I don't always want to be draining it every time I have to, you know, leave camp. So how am I going to do that? Adding a valve stem. Got this off Amazon. Did a lot of searching around. There's a lot of one-way valves, a lot of different things. Kind of like this because it's very mechanical. It is set up to vent a gas can so it just pours smoothly. But I just like the idea of it, just unscrew it and let it vent and screw it down and it's sealed. And they're metal caps. This really should work pretty good and be a really super easy install. Yeah, kind of nothing to it there, just wide open. There was a one-way valve in this originally, but yeah, it's in there somewhere. Oh, Yahtzee, right there. And I'll fish that out. What do you do? You know, it's cheap. This is what we fix it for. Yeah, I hate those. It's pointless. Hold up. Drill bit, stickers, stems. Wrench. And it's cool, they kind of give you this wire here to fish. Like I said, if it's, you know, it's meant to straighten out and run through a gas can, but I'm not going to need that. Yeah, I like it. Metal cap. And it's weird, but I like that it has this so I don't lose it. It'll just be there. Unscrew it when it's time to use and screw it when it's done. It does have a red seal inside. I don't know if that's showing. Doing all this on the GoPro because I'm feeling lazy tonight. It's just wide open. I mean, it's like easy. So it shouldn't take long at all. I had to stop. How tight is that? I had to stop to show that. Crazy. Put a little seal down on there. And then put the washer. Then our valve stem. Oh, that's getting close. It will snug down. I could just simply get right next to me and grab a socket, but what fun is that? It's not fun. That's tight. All right, cool. Anyway, thread. just like that. All right. So yeah, finished product. That was entirely by accident. I didn't realize I was gonna fit so snugly. Sweet. Now I gotta test it.
Now I have managed and worked in the automotive field for over 13 years. Rule number one always is measure twice, cut once. I didn't follow my own rules.
No real good way of doing this. Just gonna tip it up here. Certainly not leaking out of the cap, but I do see a drip there. And I don't know. It could be water. It was pretty darn rainy last time I went out. We'll see. But I mean, that looks pretty good. Two obvious things happened there. When I opened it to vent it, like diesel, it puked everywhere. So it kind of like held diesel in there. It's not really the end of the world. However, this is. It's. I thought for certain we were going to have enough clearance. Yeah. The easy, obvious answer is drill a hole for it, make room, pop it up. Okay, so we're back and did a lot of thinking about it. I don't think there's any way I can get around not drilling a hole for this thing. It's just too tall. And because I already drilled a hole in this, you know, the odds of finding another one of these without buying an entire new tank isn't going to happen. And I don't really want water or snow or whatever I'm going to be doing out there in the wild using this, getting into it. So I ordered up a little hood that we'll put to the top of it. So yeah, let's see what happens. Define overkill, but you know what? Whatever. It's nice and smooth. Looks good. Really centered. Sweet. I forget how just messy routers are. Holy cow. Thank you. Okay, a little bit cleaned up now. As you saw, I had to take that strap off it. Again, one of the things you don't think about whenever you're in the midst of doing things, but it would work with this off. I could close it, but with it on, I can't do anything. So whatever, when I'm using it, I'll just unscrew it and we'll put it in here. That's all there is to it. But the screws here don't stick out too much. Take that off. That, I mean, back to normal. Little freaking power vent on the front of it. Yeah, ram air, buddy. I need to turn that sticker around. I didn't even think about that. It looked good sitting here, but when it's supposed to be the other way around. So yeah, but yeah. I might even actually, let's see, I didn't even look at this thing. Hold on. Oh, it's a little offset in there, but it's okay. But I might even actually like stuff some like really big open cell foam in there to help kind of keep, you know, dust and debris out when it's venting. I absolutely will just stuff it in there so it can still breathe, but it's not going to be like a little air filter. Like I said, it's ram air. Ooh, look at that. Weird. Colorful. That is really strange. Really sooty. Anyway, cool. Well, hope you guys enjoy it. It's funny to me how just a quick little modification becomes like a week-long ordeal. And now we have a totally different setup. But all in all, I'm pretty pleased with it. It'll still keep the weather out. It'll be good. All right. We'll catch you on the next one.